For this video, we have this message, which is 327 characters long. Well, that's too many characters to fit into this SL data type that we used in a previous video. It can only handle 256 characters. So how do we get around that? Normally, a PLC programmer would break this big long string up into shorter strings and use some interlocking logic, or better yet, some stage programming to send each part sequentially, with the final part having that termination character appended to it for the view mark. And that's certainly doable, but with the DoMore, there's a much, much easier way. Since the DoMore memory is completely configurable, why not make your own string variable that is long enough? It's so easy. Just right-click in the project browser and select Memory Configuration. Click Add Memory Block, give it a name. This is our ViewMark string, so we'll call it VS. It's a string data type. And we want it to be able to hold, let's say, about 512 characters. And we'll go ahead and create, I don't know, 4 of these for right now. We can change it later if we want to. That's it. We just created a new memory type that holds strings, characters, and it's long enough to hold our ViewMark string. It's warning us here that this change can't be written to the DoMore right now because it's running. That's okay. We're going to change it in a minute anyway. Now, why did we choose 512 characters for this memory type? Because it's large enough to hold our 327 character message, of course, but more importantly, if we go look at the ViewMark software, we see that the longest message the ViewMark software can generate is 500 characters. So 512 characters for our new data type is just about perfect. So to send a long ASCII message from the DoMore to the ViewMark, all we have to do is take that simple short message example we used in a previous video and modify the data type. So here we go. We'll swap out the SL0 with my new VS string. And of course, we need to use our new string. Let me go grab that. Back to the ViewMark software. Here's my big long string, which is generating that display. I say copy. Go back to my DoMore software and swap out the string. If I'm careful, I can preserve my quotes and my termination character. Let's make sure. Okay, we got our opening quote, our end quote, and our termination character. Perfect. That will be placed into VS0. Then we come down to stream out, and we say we want to stream out VS0, and we're done. Now we can send the longest messages the ViewMark software can generate with no effort on our part at all. How about that? I would even suggest you create a ViewMark message type for all of your ViewMark strings. That way you never have to worry about how long your string is. Let's go and accept that, save it, and write it out to the PLC. Let's make sure everybody has their status turned on. And let's go ahead and add that ViewMark string to our data view. And we'll monitor the length too. Now I have some stuff in here from a previous example. Let me go ahead and get rid of that. Let's just put a couple space characters in there. Okay, so my ViewMark string has blanks in it, 2 of them actually, and we're ready to go. So if I reach down to the DoMore and I flip switch X0, it should place this string into VS0. And sure enough, it does. You can see the string here and down here in our data view. Here's the string, and there's the number of characters that we placed into that string. Now, if I reach down to my DoMore and I flip switch X7, it should send that string outstream out to the internal serial port and, of course, to the ViewMark. And sure enough, it works exactly like that short string example in the previous video. But we didn't have to do any interlocking code or stage programming or anything. It's easy. Well, that ought to be enough to get you going. Check out the other videos to learn more about using the DoMore PLC with the ViewMark LED display. And let us know if you have any questions. Automation Direct customer support is always free and just a phone call or an email away. Spend less, do more from Automation Direct.